are roaming to the top, though. You can see Wolf.
Can catch him.
Wolf immediately went to roam top. And
oh, he's caught! He's caught! CloudJJ! Oh! Falls down Baby! And Samsung Galaxy! They're not gonna do it yet! Baby! Right for it! Here comes Faker! Flash over the wall, and nobody does!
Gravity field. Oh, while that's happening, Rule is in trouble. The last shot doesn't kill him, but no, Deadly Flurry. Is there enough HP? Rule is sticking around. Summoner heal has been used. Bengi is sticking around in the jungle. Rule is running for his life. Now Ambition challenging Bengi. Bengi gets rooted up. The Brambleback is fighting. To Bengi. Here comes Crown. Gets a reply. Poor JJ and Crown still in the jungle.
Ambition was trying to go back and get his own blue when Bengi so chooses. This makes it difficult for Crown. Look, he already burns some summoner spells, and he's ulted now twice just to shove out the wave. Might have some kill threat.
Flash is still getting
got
the last tick.
He's on
Crown. Solo kills Faker. It's on to Bang. Bang reloads and Ace in the hole. Not going to be enough. Bang and Wolf don't get the kill. Look at the minimap. Ambition, he's coming in from behind. Sonic Wave needs to hit. Flash kick into the Sonic Wave. Now Bang's the target. Ambition sidesteps away. Bengi's running in. The kill! He outplays the Ragnarok and the Ghost. CloudJJ will go down, gets run down, and Bengi's got a second.
All right, so much just happened that all started.
They don't have Pink Ward control in the Dragon area, and they need to actually go and take some pressure back, which is they're going for now.
And that's just easy. And Ambition gets dunked.
Baker uses his third summoner spell, Bengi, to get revenge on Samsung.
Once again, the Dancer on Infernal is set
They're
up.
Gonna pull the trigger. Crown
is not there. Duke's not there either.
Crown was doing blue buff, which is why they're starting
for
this. So
steal
just
only.
To steal.
Steal indeed. He gets it! Miracle play! Exactly as you want it to.
Here comes the big moment, though. Baron has been started up, and SKT try and chase Samsung back into their own jungle.
Oh, they're going to be able to two-man this with the shields and the autos. Is support now coming in from Beck? Samsung have no idea. They're simply too late. SK Telecom secure Baron. On the bottom lane, Bengi takes a lot of damage, but not enough to be worried just yet. Pillar of Ice throws Yuve backwards. Gonna sidestep away once again. Great! Wolf is pinned against the wall. A lot of damage coming out, but the shield! That's a kill for Ruler! Now SKT, they've got to run for their lives. Look for the shockwave. That's gonna be game changer, even in a 4v5. Yuve's rooted in place. The shockwave pulls him backwards. Whoa. That's gonna pop the GA. Now Curtain Call, second and third shot, not doing the most damage.
Just follow Faker.
Can they chase him? Good pin against the wall once again. Well, Duke went in a 1v2 earlier. This is now a 3v1.
He's dead.
Oh, they'll kill him twice.
Gates and Frozen Domain. That's the GA popped. Obviously, Samsung will try to give this kill over to Ruler. Everyone backs away. Ruler gets another. And SKT playing a little fast and loose.
Another mistake. And that big fan. This is why you don't give up hope and you go for the farm for late. So this is going to be burned out very quickly, and SKT will get their second Baron.
Duke teleporting way into the back line.
But he's completed the teleport, jumps onto Ruler, 90 caliber, Sonic Wave, everything's connecting.
Samsung is so far back in this play, and this goes to show the lack of vision. If SKT gets Baron and Elder, that's just a massive power priority. We thought about Samsung being able to fight back, but if they're not able to harass an Elder at all, that's big trouble.
Not in the right place, not able to...
Right now, playing as a team, all members closing in at once.
Good damage onto Crown, not going to be enough to kill him. He uses the Chaos Storm as well. That will allow the inhibitor to go down. SKT still got Baron. Ruler! The shockwave kills him! SK Telecom, they've opened the base! Even though Wolf gets knocked away, Yuve can't do enough. Good pin onto Faker. Samsung aren't done just yet. Trying to rely on those Nexus turrets to help out. No damage from Ruler though. Nexus turret number one is going to fall. Crown's trying to wave clear, but it's against Baron empowered minions. Duke gets pushed away. The Nexus tower still stands. SK Telecom looking for the minions, looking for the support, looking for the tower. Yuve's got a GA, so does Ambition. It's been popped already though. He's in trouble. There's a kill onto Faker. Not enough for the game just yet. Ambition dashes to safety, safeguards to a teammate. It's a double kill for Crown. He's not willing to give up the game just yet. And SK Telecom
kill the last Nexus turret if they don't immediately retreat to clear them.
There's no time for Samsung. They have to go. The minions.
That's a two-man route. Bang and Wolf are in trouble. The Poppy Hammer throws up. Shockwave pulls up Vision into it. Bang is down. Where is Faker? Gravity Field splitting them up. It's a double kill for Ruler. He's looking for more.
Cuvée
fighting for his life. Cuvée and Bengi, they're going toe-to-toe. The GA was popped. Here comes Duke in the base. The Nexus turret still stands. Ambition is clearing. And Samsung Galaxy live to fight another day.
Samsung stand tall, but the Nexus turret still goes down. There.
It's a Bang and Faker both getting knocked up by the Poppy ult, but bought them time to finish them off. And they're going to get Baron.
Oh my word. Baron is secured.
Trevor, never say it.
With their AD carry, Ambition
with the pick, baby.
Wolf is in trouble, flashes away, not going to die yet.
They got him!
Ruler, not going to get the kill. Ace in the hole, his body blocked, but it's not done yet. Teleport completes from Duke. Chaos Storm atop all the Stranglethorns. Duke is still locked up. Bengi's running for his life.
So much at this point. If you have to walk into an SKT team that are threatening, Ambition has been so good at stealing objectives with this fight, but he's not going to risk it here. They know they cannot fight a 4v5 sacrificing his life.
The reason they're trying this is because Crown and Ruler actually have enough damage to kill him here, but Ruler!
Ruler's in trouble, but Bengi takes so much damage. Flash away from 4JJ. Ambition's looking for Bengi. Faker gets caught up.
Whoa! He's
out! That's the shutdown. Faker goes golden. He's killed by Ruler. What can Ruler do?
Oh.
Nothing! He's killed by Bang! That's AD carry and mid laner down. There is a reply onto Bang though as Cuvée doing work in the back line. Wolf is pinned against the wall. Duke has to fight this one out for SK Telecom. He's trading with Cuvée. He traded. He sold.
Who can kill Trundle right now? All the damage from Samsung is dead.
Nobody. The inhibitor is the target. Ambition forced a ward hop to safety. SK Telecom take another inhibitor.
They're gonna do it.
They turn their attention to the Nexus. They're gonna go for the Nexus. Duke is stunned temporarily. The Nexus is being killed. There's two members of Samsung against three members of SK Telecom, and the Nexus goes down. The defending world champions win game one.
Take right there.
Well, jungler's now going to be meeting toe-to-toe. Level Check. 7 advantage for Ambition. Gets a ward down. Lamb's Respite is available. Tidal Wave captures both of Samsung Galaxy's bottom
lane.
Ambition with the Lamb's Respite. It's first blood to Ambition. Body block on the first two shots from Wister. The third and the fourth gets nobody.
Beautiful.
Now Faker's the target. Gets caught up by the red buff. Slowed down. Crown looking for a target. They may want to go
they
for a
more.
Dive.
Crown's full health with both summoner spells up. All summoner spells are up for SKT though.
They're closing in, trying to push the minion wave first, and there goes the counterattack from Ryze.
The realm warp not going to be enough to
go
for range, but the flash does. Now, Faker and Wolf, they're in enemy.
The last trade, Duke Meganaut out, force Cuvée's flash. This should be an easy
no
dive.
Ultimate.
Here
Uh-oh.
Comes Ambition as well. Knocked against the wall. Faker is gifted a kill. And they just made that look easy.
And we talk about the ebb and flow of
down.
The map.
Here comes a cannon with an ultimate.
Cheeky play there over the back of the Dragon Pit. Pink Ward so they know there's nobody to see them.
Bang and Wolf have no summoner spells. The teleport's coming down.
It's a party.
It will be a
Meganaut.
Slicing Maelstrom stuns SK Telecom. Duke Meganaut's out. They've tried it one for one. Ambition doesn't get the respite down. Faker realm warps in. Gets the reply kill. It ends up being a 2-for-2.
SKT can equalize plays that no other team can equalize.
All the information that SKT is working with, though. You know, as much as we talked about the play being set up here.
Kicked into the wall, and that just looks so, once again, so easy, so well executed.
And they know they can cleanly go for that 2v2.
Ace in the hole's available for Ruler. The exhaust, the flash, the heal. Ruler's face palming. He's flashed forward aggressively multiple times. This time it hurts him.
SKT making informed decisions. They have wards seeing every member of Samsung, whereas Samsung
has
nothing.
Ambition, can he get the Lamb's Respite? Yes, but it won't be enough to get the kill just yet. Jumps back away, Dance of Arrows, and the three-man SKT, they shut him down.
Four Duke in the split-pushing battle. Kennen, yes, is going to be great for those team fights, trying to flank in, but uh-oh. Core JJ taking fire.
Aqua Prison locks up Core JJ and whispers fourth shot. Bang! You're down.
That's three solo deaths in a row by Samsung.
Level 11, 12 rather on Faker. Round Warp comes in. Cubase got Slicing Maelstrom and Flash. Got no minions under the tower. Got a Protobelt forward. Duke takes a turret shot. Flash forward for Cubase. Looking for the Lightning Shuriken. Shut down Duke with the Boomerang.
It's incredible the speed at which SKT make their calls. I mean, oh, here we go.
Ambition going to buy some time. There's a little bit of support from Cubase coming out, but it's not going to be enough just yet. Ambition dances around. Mounting Dread, Wolf Frenzy, throw everything at Faker, and it's not going to count. 3-0-3. Put yourself in a position to get punished. Now they're behind in gold. If you look at the mini-map, full pressure.
Oh, no.
Ruler's going to flash away from the tidal wave. 4JJ's already used his flash. He gets shut down by Bang, who's now on a killing spree.
And to elaborate a little bit more on your point about, you know, how hard the ultimates, the hard CC that they have is the Cassiopeia and the Kennen ultimates. Those have to hit multiple targets, have to lock people in place, because there is no tank for this team. Until Cubase is able to, you know, get his Zhonyas and buy some time that way, it's all about Ambition's ultimate, which has been down.
Yeah, not available. Look at that.
Yeah, and it would also require them to be able to set up at all. But SKT has been so far
in mode with the Caitlyn here as the Baron being taken. There's not really any counterplay here from Samsung. It's a completely dark map. They would have to do some crazy move to even go get them. It would probably cost them a lot of their lives, so. Yeah. Defensive play is, again, the name of the game.
Yeah. Way up in farm against Ambition. In this game, he's equalizing the farm of the Kindred in the late game and getting picks like this.
Oh, the fourth shot misses, but Bengi doesn't care. He jumps in. Oh, while we were looking at that top lane, Faker had a three-level advantage over Crown.
Still Wavecure champions, but SKT is up to nearly 6,000 on this Baron power play. With all that being said, though, we're 1.5 games in to Worlds.
Well, that's a dead Ambition once
again.
Oh,
dear.
Now Bang is going to be the target. The Esma, Tidal Wave. Cubase can't find anybody more. Slicing Maelstrom is down, and all of a sudden, Duke turns the pressure around. Bang, bang. Unstoppable as Cubase is shut down. Duke is going to be able to Mega Gnar out. Not too long. Hops forward, looking for more.
Oh!
4JJ kicked against the wall, locked against the wall. Duke gnaws Crown. Petrifying Gaze not going to be enough. And Duke will get popped, but just the GA. Round Warp from Faker will allow him to get a double kill onto Ruler at 30 minutes into the game. SKT against all of SKT's. Rune Prison down. This time gets the respite out, but it won't be enough. Cubase caught out, sent back to the fountain. The Samsung Galaxy, they cannot defend their Nexus. SK Telecom jumping forward for more. CoreJJ on the steps of the fountain is killed by the god Faker himself. And SKT are 2-0 in the finals.
Through the river. He's going to try coming through the brush, though.
All right, flashes are available for Bank.
Here we go.
Wolf,
number one.
It comes up. Star Surge. The Star Voice of Light locks down Bank. Celestial Expansion is out. Here comes Bengi. Bengi gets a cocoon. First blood onto Bank. The Tidal Wave is flashed away from as CoreJJ runs for his life.
Exactly as we said it. Through the darkness, though, Bengi's moving up to the top side to look at Cubase.
All right, let's follow the cocoon from Bengi. He needs to try lock Cubase down. The pillar actually blocks it. Oh, once again,
wow.
Easy peasy. Duke and Bengi literally took no damage.
Shred the resist, tank the turret with the guy healing off of him, and they...
It's a huge amount, especially when they're not roaming. This time around, Crown's going to get surrounded. Three members, Shockwave.
No summoners.
Decent stun onto Faker, but Cocoon locks him up. Teleport's being channeled. Duke may get interrupted. It looks like he was. Flash over the wall from Ambition, and Bengi follows over. Curtain Call fired, and CoreJJ blocked one shot. The third and started to build and grow. And it's by punishing mistakes, by punishing tendencies of their opponent's team. Ruler has been left alone multiple times. Look how well executed this dive is. Cubase gets a decent stun, but some damage onto Bengi and Duke. And, you know, it's just, it is methodical and calculated.
Yeah, and the play
is the longevity of Bengi and Faker. Both of those players have sat on the bench. Those are going to be the only two players, you know, with the triple crown.
Oh, Cubase, run the other way, buddy.
Yep, only see. Deadly Flourish could lock him down, and it does. A couple extra shots, and Cube sets it up. Bang brings it home.
Triple cup. And the Infinity Edge also. The last two big World Championship victories have been very impressive. Now they go for Ruler.
Oh,
Bubble, Tidal Wave, Curtain Call. Maybe that is the Curtain Call. SK Telecom sieging the mid in a turret at 25 minutes.
Where's Crown going to go?
Q's going to throw up the pillar. Does get stunned up, and GLQ's already been used by Crown. Decent pin, stunned onto Duke. This might be the first kill. Dragon's Rage kick, Voice of Light is sidestepped, and Wolf is being tagged by those stars. Q-Bay stuns Wolf against the wall. Still not down. Shockwave catches two, and finally, Samsung Galaxy are on the board. It's 1-7, but now they're routed, running for their lives. Faker's on a killing spree at 3-0-1-1, and they trade.
The only players to ever do that. We talk about how long they've been a duo lane together, playing nearly 300 pro games. Oh, Ruler's done for.
Curtain call not even needed.
Wolf and Bang speeding each other up, healing each other. They're going for more.
They are indeed. Flash away from poor JJ. To save his life.
World Championships are going to back it up as well. Bang also making a legacy for himself alongside Bang.
QB's being run down by Bang. Flash away from QB.
Oh!
Knock up onto Duke. That was a good play by QB to find the stun.
Make them pay even more for it.
Well, this would be a time to try and get back. They scout it with the Trisha Barrage. You want SKT to make
Juve
it
has
off.
Teleport. Samsung can try and make it play back.
A lot of damage.
Ruler's jump forward. Already used the True Shot Barrage. Wolf is killed by Ambition. It looks like Samsung are coming back. They've killed Faker. Found Bengi. And moving on to Duke. Crown. He's tagging him with the stars. They're peeling backwards. Baron's the target.
They can get it. They already have four Drakes. None of them are bounced, but they've killed three. Bang would have his ultimate, and Duke doesn't. So this is gonna slingshot it back!
Yeah, SKT's so risky, they slip up here.
Do you believe Staples? Samsung Galaxy, pick up the Baron!
And it came out of nowhere.
Poised to defend.
There is a ward behind them. SKT do have teleport available on Duke, but Kyubey is keeping sight on
Ambition
Duke.
Going for Faker!
Faker's down! They've got him! Faker's down! Crown is pushing forward. It's at the cost of Ambition's life. Crown is zoning away SK Telecom. Another Kyubey again, zoning. Ruler's on the inhibitor, knocking it away. Crown's very aggressive.
Very careful here.
Flash available. Damage out. Kyubey on the front line. Doesn't find the stun. Onto Duke. Ruler and Kyubey running for their lives. Faker's up in 10 seconds. Ruler, he Yorkin shifted forward. He's very aggressive. Caught out. Locked down. Cocooned up. Shut down by Bang. And SKT defend the inhib.
Banky and Bang played that backline so incredibly. Watch for Bang to hold on to that crit shot as long as he can. Uses it on the Baron. He's got to reload now.
Kyubey's now pushing forward, stuns up Bang, already trying to back away. Kyubey's in trouble.
Tifa's
verdict has sent SKT away. Wolf gets hit by the Baron. It's helping Samsung. Wolf goes down. Core JJ gets his first kill of the game. Bengi and Duke, they want to reply. Not only do Samsung stop Baron, they get a kill as well.
SKT is here.
Curtain calls firing, lands onto Kyubey. Star Surge not going to stun anybody. Crown's taking damage, throws down the GLP. Baron's helping out. Only Kyubey is caught. Faker's tagged. Bang's on the back line. Faker uses the hourglass. He's bought so much time.
He's
popping. Faker is killed. Duke gets his GA popped as well. He's going to spawn, but here comes Bang. Bang's running low on ammo. Whisper wants blood, but he's running away. Deadly Flourish finally closer.
Ambition's not there.
Don't think they can get there quick enough. 5,000 hit points. Maybe enough for a challenge. Duke is on the front line, looking to take down Crown. Elder Dragon is secured by SKT. Crown takes so much damage from the curtain call. Kyubey's trying to back away. The call is run. The call is run. Samsung are trying to follow Ruler. Kyubey's flashed over the wall. Ruler arcane shifts to safety. The dash, the dive. Nobody's died just yet, but Samsung are ticking.
The Ezreal came through, and I saw it at 400 health, so that was very close to a steal. But as you say, the health bar is too low. Looks like SKT can get this, but
teleport.
They're trying to stop it.
SKT have got so much damage. I don't think they'll get here in time. Baron down to 1,500. Looks like it's secured. Baron and Elder for SKT. Kyubey's now left alone. No support until Ambition safeguards his way into the pit.
Faker has Shockwave.
They're locked in. Stunned up against the wall. Bengi is popped. The GA looking to respawn. Kyubey still running for his life. Ruler, True Shot Barrage. Gonna be dodged by the
Baron.
Bang. He's out of mana. That's a great hammer. Ambition is still fighting in the front line. Ruler running low on mana. Yorkin shifts forward. Training. That's a shutdown. That's another. Duke is now the next target. GA pop inside the pit. Ruler sends the Mystic Shot over the Tri-Bush. Duke is going to die. It's a double for Ruler. SKT lose 3.
150 at the moment.
We're approaching the point where minions don't matter at all.
Oh, look at that damage. Good flash. Voice of Light on
the plate. They're
going
to get him.
Core JJ. They're looking to shut him down. Stranglethorns catches Duke. It's Core JJ that kills Faker. Duke uses the subjugate. He's running for his life, but you can't outrun five members of Samsung.
Faker goes for the plate. Doesn't get it. SKT.
You don't peel for the fight. You're going to find out.
Here we go, all five in the pit. They'd want to peel off. They saw Faker in the lane. He can't make it to the fight immediately. They might just try to burst it.
It looks like they're going for the burst. Ambition dives back in. It's secured. Samsung get the Baron. Now they need to win the fight. Ambition dives in. GA's not popped just yet. Crown, Core JJ. They're gone.
Core Shockwave.
And Stalker. Look at that hammer.
There's a Shockwave.
Shockwave. Faker uses the hourglass to stay alive. Ambition, Ruler, and Crown running for their lives. They need to survive Duke. Bengi flashes forward. His GA is now popped. Ruler's still got a lot of hit points, a lot of mana, but he doesn't have a lot of support. Crown is down, and Ruler's running for his life. He has flash and heal, but three members to deal with.
He fights the
powered minions. It's not done yet. Flash and heal still up for Ruler. Here comes Ambition, sidesteps away from the deadly flourish.
This is 3 versus 5, and Samsung are cornered. SKT close in.
They
but Ambition, Faker gets him.
But they lose Ruler. Now Faker's the target. Ambition's got a GA. Kyubey's doing what he can. He too can survive for a few seconds longer. Flash away from Ambition. The Baron still stands. Can he defend? They need to buy time. 30 seconds for Core JJ. Another Shockwave.
Oh.
Shockwave started the fight. A Shockwave ends the fight.
But that goes to show how long SKT to a spot on the map. And with three exposed inhibitors, if Samsung get the right rotation, they can force it. But they can't get caught out.
This is so scary.
Bang takes a lot of damage.
Here comes Crown. Voice of Light doesn't do anything. Bang's in trouble. But so's Ambition. True Shot Barrage will not be enough to kill him or pop the GA. But it is Ambition that does. He needs to safeguard out and does not do so. SKT get themselves the first kill of the fight. Samsung are not backing away yet. They've got a big minion.
Oh,
Faker finds him. That might be the pick that wins the game. Wolf loses his life, as does Bengi. It continues to be a 3v3, but Bang and Faker stay alive.
Faker's
fight. You have to teleport in early because they need every member there at the start of the fight. So you have to be very careful about that long teleport time.
Curtain Call's going to tag Ruler with one. Ambition the second and third. Dragon is still tagged. It's not regenerating.
Oh,
teleport's now coming in. It might be too late. 4,500 hit points. Ambition's looking to chase out. This Shockwave still available. The Poppycopter sends three away. Duke and Faker left alone. The Dragon's still tagging.
Bengi's not there to finish Elder.
Here comes the rest of it. Let's reset. The Star Surge not going to lock anybody up. But Crown's down. He's tagged. He's down. He's killed. But at what cost?
Both
GA. The Dragon's still alive, helping out. Ruler is now on the wrong side of the fight. He's in trouble. Flash is still available. The Dragon, oh my god, it reset again.
Down Faker posts on is because he flashes in the proper direction. SKT, though, right for Elder. I think this
Samsung are running for Baron, though, right now, trying to establish vision control and force
SKT to face attack
that Ambition. Ambition!
Ambition steals the Elder Dragon. He gets away. Let's see what happens. SKT don't have as many tools this time around.
Flash.
Bubble comes out. Secured by Samsung. If Samsung can close this out, they're on the pressure. The Nexus turrets are being focused, and there's so many minions.
Three inhibitors down, double stacked up, super minions empowered by the Baron buff. This is the onslaught. Samsung, we're waiting to pull off.
Duke's in trouble. He gets kicked the wrong way, though. Crown throws out the Voice of Light. Bang is down, then forced away. He's onto the fountain to regen. The first Nexus turret is down. I asked if you believe. Staples, you got behind Samsung. They're now in the final fight. Stranglethorns buys down. Crown's in trouble, but it's Duke that gets killed. Ruler, Arcane shifts forward once again. So aggressive.
They're so low.
Crown barely lives, and he's going to have to go back to base to heal after that one. But then
Samsung
got a building without him.
It's not over.
Nexus.
The Nexus is down. Samsung stun the world and defeat SKT for their first game in finals.
Switch. here they come.
All right, Ambition, let's look for the shockwave. Again, mid laners on mid laners, junglers on junglers, but this isn't fair. Here comes the support. Crown flashes away. Ambition's running
the
low. He uses the kick to Zen Blank flying. Asharo comes out. Blank takes a couple extra shots, but nobody dies. Up in the top lane, Duke and Cuvée, they're going toe-to-toe. Slicing Maelstrom burns through. Flash for flash. Cuvée, first blood. Solo kills Duke.
Cuvée came into
the clutch moment after an incredibly close fight in mid lane. Knows no one else can come there. He makes it happen.
The curtain call.
Bang!
Bang!
Look for him.
Bang! Bang! Blank flashes for his life. Samsung, get another.
Ruler! Ruler!
All right, let's see. More pressure in the mid lane. Shockwave traded for Chaos Storm. I've seen that movie before. Ooh. Here comes the junglers. Blank has jumped onto Crown. Unstable matter and left bounce. This should be the kill. Crown gets safeguarded. He sidesteps. He dodges. The ebb and flow takes him down. Cuvée's in trouble, taking so much damage. We'll stun Blank up to buy some time. Blank may be able to charge the elastic slingshot. He swings and misses. We'll get rooted in place by CoreJJ. Buy some time. Cuvée still running for his life. Still not down. He's going to lightning rush away. Proto belts. He's not as big, but how does SKT play from behind? Let's see as Blank is being jumped on. Look at curtain call. This is going to be a target of Blank. Teleports matched one for one in the river in mid lane. Maelstrom. Bang just gets blown up. Blank gets turned on. He gets kicked back into the mid lane. Cuvée is going to get dropped. So that makes it a one for one. Looks like Blank's able to get away for now.
Yeah,
as well. Already two Drakes to zero for Samsung. If he gets Crown, no. Got Flash.
He does indeed flash away from Crown. Ambition sidesteps the arrow. It was CoreJJ that ate it. He's now going to flash into the blue pit and continue backing away. Blank, elastic slingshots over the wall. There's still a tower
there
for Crown and Ambition to get in. Very good Aqua Prison and another elastic slingshot. Crown will go down. Throws down a gravity field to buy some escape time.
SKT relentless. They have so many of these CC. Neither of the carries for Samsung have flash up at the moment.
Well, Lula doesn't need it.
Gotta walk yourself out there.
Bitten's gonna safeguard in a second. Gets caught by Let's Bounce. The kick, the shockwave delivery system. That allows a kill onto Ambition. Curtain Call is only tagging the tank. And Blank's coming in from behind. And the fight's now gonna break out. Gravity Field will pull Blank backwards. That should be the GA pop. Cell Division still available. Curtain Call interrupted. Very good tidal wave. He's found three. Charges up the Maelstrom. The slingshot. Fakers down. Samsung get three.
Quick shot. Just like we talked about. Now it's going to be the Baron for them as well.
And it's nothing that SKT can do about it at this point. They meander into a fight in Samsung's jungle and get absolutely obliterated.
It was probably a team call there because they went with Asharo. They wanted to engage on it.
Tidal Wave was thrown down in the mid lane.
They got Faker!
Galaxy, they've killed Faker. We didn't see the setup, but it doesn't matter. With Baron buff looking to make a play. I can see Ambition's...
That Asher initiation won't be possible.
Oh, Ambition's looking for Faker again. Not going to find him just yet. Let's Bounce, interrupting the possibility of a
dead.
Ambition is now down. SKT turning it around. CoreJJ gets caught out. The Mega Knock comes down as well. That's two kills for SKT. Samsung unable to find a kick this time around.
It's a matter of how much help he has. He has no one to help him right now.
All right, there's no support. This should equal a kill. The hop, the bounce,
final
shot. Not going to find his target. The stun does. Cuvée combos with Ruler.
And the two inhibitors,
you know, taking the half step backward, eats the root, ends up going down. And now Ambition once again.
He gets caught up by Enchanted Crystal Arrow, the bubble, the bounce, everything. Chaos Storm is buying some time. Bang is forced to run away. Look at the damage from those ticks over and over, and the tower falls.
Yeah, but I like SKT.
Throughout the series, playing from behind, and now they've started Baron proactively.
Cuvée is hoping they come into the choke so he can get the flank on them, but he can't get caught on. He's going for Faker!
He's gonna find Faker and kill him, but he used the slicing maelstrom. Blank is in the pit with Ambition. That's a good Asharo.
No.
Picked up
got
a Samsung Galaxy. Blank is now left alone in the pit. Duke running for his life. A couple more tags. Cuvée can't find the stun just yet. Tidal Wave sends him fishing. Crown throwing down those death rays over and over. Blank is exhausted. The curtain call, the gravity.
Oh,
kills. It's a double for Bang.
Holy Bank comes up huge right there. He's able to save the game for SKT.
It's not over. Blang slingshots into the mid lane. Core JJ's looking to bounce him down. The ebb, the flow, not going to be enough for the kill just yet. Here comes Ambition. Over. Ruler's on a rampage. Ambition looking for the Sonic Wave.
Bang sets another world championship record this series, 460 CS. Ambition is looking for Wolf, he's caught in the jungle.
Ivan on his own here.
He's completely 100%. By himself, gets the Dragon's Rage, eats a Shockwave. A lot of ultimates used. Samsung now,
combo
away. It's not reset just yet. Curtain call
onto
Wolf. Is going to get interrupted by the tidal wave. And Qubank has found Bang and Freighton. Push them away. But Blank is bouncing all up in Samsung Galaxy. The shockwave kills Qubank. Bank is going low. Blank is going to flash away. Duke's in trouble.
Oh!
Ruler can't get the kill. He does in the end. Sends him packing with a deadly flourish. Now Duke's in trouble. The GA's pop.
Oh!
Ruler gets another, finds the shutdown, turns his attention into Duke, and Samsung Galaxy are pushing
minions into the base.
Couple of pings on the top inhibitor, the rest of Samsung pushing around. Ambition and Blank starting to go toe-to-toe, jungler on jungler action. Shockwave catches Ruler, but the Defiance comes up. Crown shuts him down. That's a good kill. The third inhibitor falls. Samsung waiting for the supers.
And cut all the minion waves. Qubay's here now.
Qubay is running into Blank. That's the GA. That's gone down. Cell division might still be up, and it will not matter.
With three inhibitors down and two players,
it's on Galaxy. They throw down the curtain call. The music is about to play. Silver scrapes. Cue it up, Samsung, now running for their lives. Ash Arrow onto Qubank. Get to Crown. The slicing maelstrom. That stays Bang packing. There's not done yet. The Nexus turrets are the focus. And Staples Center. Play the Silver Scrapes. Samsung and SKT are going to game five.
And
a Wolf.
Wow.
Banking.
But it goes to Wolf, however, which isn't the greatest distribution of gold. And Faker's down both summoner spells. Here comes Ambition.
Ambition's running in. Gravity fields up. That will stun Ambition under the tower. Kill is secured, but Ambition loses his life.
Banky got inexperienced range there, and he's going to be able to take up these minions. Here comes Frog! More action!
Here comes Banky and Wolf. Crown's going to sidestep, and Dodgy will get stunned up by the concussive blows. SK Telecom, 3-1.
And they jump out the gate, countering.
Play here from Banky to try and steal this away under their nose.
Back if he needs to retreat.
Fight.
A lot of damage onto Bangi. Crown posted up for this one. Flash away. Curtain call still in range. The Miasma will block the movement. Curtain call. Kill for Ruler.
And that means Ruler gets red as well. So a total backfire on that.
The game is seemingly happening on the bottom half of the map. There's a Missile Voyage. He's going to deliver Core JJ and Ambition. Flash away from Bang. He gets gobbled up from the tongue lashing. Will go down. Root in place, not going to lock down Wolf, but Crown has roamed, and Wolf gets the kill.
And that's the Core JJ playmaking right there on Tom Kent. The instant he hits
early armor penetration with that gold, and he's definitely set up to make plays, but SKT looking to go on the offensive.
Core JJ is devoured.
Ambition is here.
Ambition's running in, teleport coming down, but Qubank doesn't have his available, but Core JJ is already killed. Faker was there to join the party. Qubank continues to pressure
Careful, buddy.
The bottom inner turrets and Bangs.
Ruler had been taken so low, they just decided to call it off.
Oh, is this going to turn it around?
Now they go for it. They delay.
Here comes Core JJ and Ambition. It's all about the long
Gorgeous
game.
Gorgeous play.
Bang will get right
hit
down.
Man.
Unbelievable.
The patience on the Tom Kench right there. Thinking that after Faker equalizes this mid turret, they will sit on the slight early gold lead.
But the only difference is two Cloud Drakes for SKT. Now they're about bottom though, and Yubei's
gonna try taxi away. Gets chomped.
Wow. It's also about separating members within a team fight once it's spawned.
Absolutely agree. And as far as the map right now, oh, they might catch Faker.
Faker's the target, but he tries to turn it around. Defensive flash from Ruler. Faker is shut down. Ruler gets the kill. Teleport's completed for Duke as well as Cuvée. Unbreakable is up. Ash Arrow stuns up. Poor JJ. That's not the most important target. Oh. Petrifying Days flashed away from. Duke is caught down. Core JJ licks him to death. The tower is the focus, and Samsung has the advantage.
Will regen.
Faker's ghosting.
Ash Arrow, where will it go? Bang, looking for the target, connects.
They burst.
JJ stunned up. Bengi is gonna kick him backwards. Core JJ's down. Teleport cancelled again by Cuvée.
So big for them to also get the teleport out there in addition.
It's actually Samsung who is pushing back up towards the mid lane because Faker's in the side wave.
Well, this time around, Wolf is not there to block off the curtain call. The final shot from Whisper is being held. A very long time, finally blocked off. Here comes Bengi, you kick back
the kick.
There's no Ragnarok, loses his life. They've traded jungler for jungler. They only send Wolf away. Cuvée's caught up on the gravity field, forced to flash defensively.
Not gonna work though, and they lose out on a bit of the time where they did have some momentum.
He gets devoured by Core JJ, he's in so much trouble. Flashes away to safety, curtain call not up, and Core JJ dies. Why were they so far forward?
Ruler has done that multiple times. Gets
Baron at half, and they have the vision control.
Here comes Cuvée and Crown. Petrifying Gaze is available. It's now a 2v4. Flash!
Oh, into that throw!
It's in so much trouble. Concussive blows. Get to Petrifying Gaze. That's just going to delay the inevitable. Crown!
These players that are new to the championship stage. At the critical moment, Ruler makes a mistake. Crown flashes in a line, and SKT punished heavily.
No flash over the wall for Elder Drake Steel on the Olaf. Huge swing. No one to haste him either. SKT immediately turned for the Baron right now.
Teleport
the Olaf cap runs for Cuvée.
The Baron's already secured, taken by SK Telecom. Cuvée finishes off the TP, turns around to try and help protect Ruler. Chaos Storm will allow Ambition. It is GA popped. And Faker with SKT, they get another kill.
Beautifully done.
Waiting for the extra super minions to flood into the base while they take this Elder Dragon to return to claim their prize.
Now we were talking about the SKT victory lap and the
flourish. Is Samsung all under pressure? This is buying time for those super minions to pour in. Kick around. Crown's able to flash so he doesn't get caught, but Cuvée's down.
And it's a war of attrition. They're just waiting for them to go back in them in a fight.
Duke flashes forward, chomps down to kill Crown. SK Telecom have got two, make that three kills. The curtain call is a fitting end to the World Championship as Samsung Galaxy are being dove under their tower. SK Telecom have overcome every challenge. They are the undisputed best team in the world. The SKT reign continues. They win their third World Championship.
And you better believe the crowd's giving a standing ovation after that one. This was an incredibly hard-fought series. SKT had to earn this one till the very end. The way they played the last 20 minutes of that fifth game was incredibly clean.
What an arduous journey it has been for this team. They had to go through RNG, the ROX Tigers, and Samsung Galaxy showing up as the final boss for them. So incredibly close.
And this year, I think more than any other, their experience shined through. They were never the best regular season team in the LCK. They weren't even the LCK champions in the summer split, but they are world champions.
They peak when it matters. They prepare for the international tournaments. And SK Telecom had elation as much as relief on their faces at the end of that five-game series.
And so much respect for the players on Samsung Galaxy. The run that they have made this year is incredible.
Yeah, they're going to be very disappointed because they were so close to that Summoner's Cup. But I agree with you, Kobe. Second place in the world. And coming into this, a lot of people would think, hey, the finals happened in the semifinals, but Samsung made sure to take it all the way to the fifth game and push SKT to the limit.
One last glimpse of the runners-up as SK Telecom hoist the Summoners Cup, your world champions for 2016.